Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us in this new Azure Portal how-to video. A few weeks ago, we did a video on how to quickly create a SQL Azure database in the cloud. Today, we'll learn how to create a SQL Azure database in the cloud, providing all the available options. And for that, we have Nina Neumann that is going to show us how to do it. So thank you very much for joining us today.
Thanks, Leon. Thanks for having me. So like Leon said, we're going to go through all of the settings available for creating a SQL database in the Azure portal. If you want to have more of a quick go through of the create to quickly get started and test it, we have another video for that. So I'm going to get started, going to the Azure portal, click create a resource, and go to SQL database. Like the other resources that I can create in the Azure portal, we have our inputs and settings organized into tabs. We have the basics tab that has the minimum set of requirements you need to enter to create the database. And for SQL database, we have one additional settings tab with all the extra useful settings that you may want to configure depending on your needs. So to get started, I'm going to select the right subscription for me, my resource group. If I wanted to quickly get started, I would just need to enter the name of the database and I could immediately go click create. But I'm going to look through my other settings. I'm going to pick the right server for me. I can search for the server name and the region that I want, but right now I'm going to create a new server for my needs. So I'm going to give it a name, enter my credentials, and I'm not going to change the region. I'm happy with that, but I am going to select allow Azure services to access this server so that I can use features like Query Editor or later connect my web app to this server. Oh, it's validating. There we go. My server name is unique, so I can continue. All right, and then I can look at additional things like if I want to put this database in an elastic pool. I could use that if I have a large number of databases and I want to manage them and monitor the performance of them together. And then I could go and I could select the pool that I want this database and other databases to be managed within. I'm going to configure this database solo. So I'm going to go to configure the compute and storage resources for this database. In here, I have the vCore-based service tiers, and I have the DTU-based service tiers. In the vCore-based service tiers, I have configurable compute and storage settings I can configure exactly based on my workload needs. Versus in the DTU tier, I would have pre-configured bundles that I can select from. This would be the DTU model would be ideal if I just want something simple and easy, something pre-configured. In the vCore model, it would be ideal if I really care about transparency and flexibility and have very specific workload needs. So the tiers available in the vCore-based model, we have general purpose, which is best for most business workloads. We have business critical, which is great for business workloads with high I/O requirements. And it offers high resiliency to failures because it has multiple isolated replicas. And then we have our newest hyperscale tier, which offers highly scalable storage up to 100 terabytes, and you pay for the storage you use as opposed to pre-configuring it. Then going back to general purpose, similar to hyperscale with pay for usage storage, we have the serverless compute tier, which is pay for usage of compute. So instead of pre-configuring and paying a fixed amount for compute, you would pay for the compute that you're using. So as I go through and configure all the settings that I care about, I can look at the cost summary and review based on the selections that I've made in this page. I can view how much is the estimated monthly cost or the usage-based cost that I'd expect to pay and get an estimate of my monthly cost so that I can predict and plan for that. So I'm happy with the settings that I have. I'm going to go ahead and continue. And at this point, I've configured everything in basics. I could go ahead and create at this point. But I'm going to go to the additional settings tab to look at what extra I have. So in here, the first thing I have is data source. By default, I'll get a blank database, but I can I can populate data into this database from a backup or from a sample. Say I have a database that I was using that became inaccessible, I could restore it to a new database from a backup, which is why I would want to use this. If I'm just testing things out in SQL database, I may want to just put sample data in there so I can get started quickly. And I have other settings that potentially I care about depending on my language, database collation. And if I care a lot about security, we have this advanced data security feature that gives me a bundle of security features that will check for vulnerabilities and threats. and, you know, give me recommendations and give me an assessment based on, you know, what is potentially wrong. And this applies to the entire servers, not just this database. So every database on the same server, every database on the same server as this database, I would get these security features and this assessment running. And I can start with a free trial. And then the last thing available for all resources that I'm creating in Azure are tags. This could, you know, help me categorize my resources. Maybe later I want to configure Azure policies, or I want to identify and organize my resources. Say, you know, my environment is dev, my customer is Contoso. I can organize and categorize that way. So I'm going to go ahead and go to review and create right before I create the resource. And, you know, take one last look at my estimated cost, view maybe the cost summary if I want to look one more time, and see the settings that I've configured for this database. It ran one last validation to make sure there aren't any issues, and then I can go ahead and create. So then, once I hit create, it takes me to this great deployment status page for every resource in Azure. It gives me, you know, status, how long is the deployment taking, what are the different things being done, right? I'm creating a database and a server, so I'll see the status of each of those as they, you know, succeed or fail.
That's great. Thank you very much, Ninar. And this, by the way, this deployment page is the same one that we have for all the other services, right?
Yep.
Perfect. So thank you very much, Ninar.
Thank you.
And thanks every one of you for watching. Please try it yourself. Leave us a comment in the comment section. Follow us on Twitter and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.
Bye.